vicissitudes of life, we step purposefully into the future with God's guidance. Minister of Education, Human Resource Development, Religious Affairs and Information, Honorable Emmeline Pierre, Chief Education Officer, Mrs. Angela Finley, District 4 Education Officer, Mrs. Curlin Eben Marshall, Mr. Robert Phillip, Counseling Department, Ministry of Education, Mr. Flavian Antwine, member of the GBSS Governing Body, President of the GBSS Parent Teachers Association, Mrs. Nerissa Jilks, past headmaster of the GBSS, Mr. Victor Ashby, Mrs. Glenda Mason Francis, parents and guardians, members of staff, graduates, media representatives, good afternoon. This evening we are celebrating the 2020 graduation exercise of the Grenada Boys Secondary School. I am your chairperson, Ms. Patrina Abraham, together with
Kenneth Dubiset.
Please stand for the national anthem.
We share in singing it together. Hail Grenada, land of ours, we pledge ourselves to thee. Heads, hearts, and hands in unity to reach our destiny. Ever conscious of God, being proud of our heritage, we with faith and courage aspire, build, advance as one people, one family. God bless our nation. At this time, we prepare ourselves to receive the entrance of the graduates. You may be seated.
Thank you.
What a journey we have had to this momentous occasion. 2020, there have never been a year like this one, and we trust God that there will never be another. And we are indeed very grateful to God for preserving us and guiding us and enabling us to navigate all the circumstances and challenges throughout this year. And we want to, as is usual at the GBSS, to set the right tone as we celebrate with our graduates today. We want to invite Pastor Stevenson Wom, who would do the prayer of invocation, lead us in the prayer of invocation.
One of the outstanding masters that passed through the Grenada Boys Secondary School was Mr. K.I. Smith, Barbadian gentleman. And I'm told, though I was not part of the school as yet, I was told that one of his favorite scriptures came from Psalm 127 and is one of the scriptures that he articulated rather regularly. I felt that it was fitting that I read these few verses, just five verses, Psalm 127. Except the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keeps the city, the watchman waketh but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. Lo, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of his womb is his reward. As arrows are in the hands of a mighty man, so are children of the youth. Happy is the man that hath his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gates. Because God is supreme, and he should be reverent more than anyone else, I would therefore ask you to stand, please, as we commit this graduation ceremony into his hands and ask his blessings. Our kind and heavenly Father, creator of heaven and earth, the seas and everything therein, things visible and invisible, things tangible and not tangible, we come to you this afternoon at this very prized and special hour. We want to thank you for all your goodness that you have extended on us. For your word declares that every good and precious gift comes from the Father of light, in whom there is no variableness nor shadow of turning. And we're indeed grateful, Lord, that you have given us life. You have stayed death away from us so that we could be thankful and grateful and appreciative of life and every good things that you have deposited into us. We're indeed grateful. We want to thank you, God, that you have taken these young men through their five or so years at this great noble institution, that you helped them through the difficult periods, that you graced them with intelligence so that they could make it at this pivotal time in their career, their life. I pray, Father, that you would bestow your blessings and graces upon them. We want to thank you in a very special way for the tutors and the staff as a whole and all the auxiliary members that in one way or the other deposited great virtues and graces in their lives to make them what they are today. We're indeed grateful. We thank you for the parents, Lord, who played such a significant role, not just bringing forth these young men into the world, but also ensuring that they were properly tutored and counseled and advised, and so that they could reach, Lord, at this stage, we do thank you so very much. And everyone who contributed one way or the other into the development of these young men, we want to say thank you in a very special way. I ask, Lord, not only your blessings upon this ceremony, but I pray as these young men get ready to move into another sphere of their lives, that they would seek even more wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, that they would make right decisions, and that they would clutch and cleave unto great sound values. I pray, Father, that this institution would continue to do what it's been doing, empowering the lives of hundreds upon hundreds and thousands upon thousands of young men, getting them ready for life ahead, and allowing them to make such salient contributions, God, to this country and by extension the world as a whole. I pray your blessings upon this ceremony in a very special way. We also, God, want to pronounce blessings on the rings that these young men will wear. They would look at them proudly, and they would remember indeed that they were fine students and products of a great noble institution. May they wear them proudly. May they look at them regularly. And may the rings also bring sweet memories of a great past and of a great sojourn in a great institution. May you bless the remaining part of this ceremony in Jesus' most holy and precious name. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you, Pastor Wilm. It is my enviable task to extend a very warm welcome to everyone present here in the hall, and also our extended audience online, as this afternoon's exercise is being streamed live, I believe on Facebook. And I want to safely say Zoom also. So it is my joy to extend a warm welcome, of course, to every parent and every guardian present, and of course all well wishers of our boys today, and of course the GBSS. And of course, a very special welcome to our specially invited guests. And earlier the protocol was established, and we continue on the established protocol. There are a few announcements that must be made at this point in time. Of course, if you have your cell phone or other device in your possession, we would like you to put it on silence or vibrate, or if you prefer to turn it off, you are welcome to do so. Additionally, in this time, when every public activity must adhere to the Ministry of Health COVID-19 protocol, I would want to enunciate some very important protocols that must be observed here at the Trade Center at this time. First, no eating and drinking in the main hall. No eating and drinking in the main hall. Secondly, masks must be worn properly for the duration of the event. From the chin to the nose must be covered. Of course, you know there's an exception for me, because I and Miss Abraham, we need to be speaking so regularly. So there is an exception for us, but at you need to observe these, the wearing, the proper wearing of your mask. And I read that again. Masks must be worn properly for the duration of the event, from the chin to the nose up. Additionally, individuals not complying will be escorted out of the building and will not be allowed to re-enter. We do not want any of that this today, so we would together observe the protocols. And also, at the end of this event, the building needs to be sanitized, so re-entering into the building will not be allowed. So at the conclusion of this graduation exercise, and when we would have all exited, there would be no re-entering of the facility as it needs to be sanitized. Okay, and I think we are all clear on those. And I want to thank you for your cooperation thus far and to say an advance thank you for your continued cooperation. At this time, we want to welcome the principal of the Grenada Boys Secondary School, who is Mr. Philip Thomas. He has that challenging responsibility to give leadership and to steer the GBSS so that we realize all the objectives and the mission and the aim of the school. And he had that very unique experience of giving leadership during this time of COVID-19, which we all are familiar with earlier in the year, and we continue to experience the ripple effect of it. And so we want to welcome him as he will share with us the principal remarks. Let's put our hands together and warmly welcome Mr. Philip Thomas.
I think I'll join the chairman and take the liberty to lower my mask at this time. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Minister of Education, Human Resource Development, Religious Affairs and Information, Honorable Emmeline Pear, Chief Education Officer, Mrs. Angela Finley, District 4 Education Officer, Mrs. Curleen Eben Marshall, Mr. Robert Phillip, Counseling Department, Ministry of Education, Pastor Stevenson Worm, Mr. Flavian Antwine, Member of the GBSS Governing Body, President of the GBSS Parent Teachers Association, Mrs. Nerissa Jilks, past headmaster of the GBSS, Mr. Victor Ashby, Mrs. Glenda Mason-Francis, parents and guardians, members of staff, graduates, media representatives, good afternoon. Today is a very special day for the family of the GBSS, and even more special for the parents and guardians of the class of 2020 and the graduates themselves. We celebrate today under the theme Overcoming the Global Challenges and Vicissitudes of Life. We step purposefully into the future with God's guidance. Ladies and gentlemen, The journey was long and tough. I want to specially commend our graduates for their tenacity and endurance. The GBSS spirit is alive and well. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2020 had several hurdles to jump over. We started the 2019-2020 school year on September the 2nd with very high expectations in spite of the challenges that existed. The work to rule years of 2018 and 2019 have its negative impacts. However, teachers and students were working to cover lost grounds. The GBSS was well poised for a very successful year. Our basketball team retained the inter-secondary school basketball championship after defeating PBC in the best of three. Congratulations to Mr. Vaughn Joseph and team members. Let's give them a round of applause, please. We were similarly prepared to retain the Intercol Athletics Championship. Our Knowledge Bowl team was also doing a fantastic job, having won all their matches. Team members consisting of Atinitan Lewis, Giovanni DeGans, Richard Francis, Seko Sam, and Tendai Hokozi must be commended. Let's give also the coaches a round of applause, Mrs. Mitchell and Ms. Stafford. Ladies and gentlemen, on Friday, March the 13th, all principals were summoned to a special emergency meeting at the Kirani James Cricket Stadium. We were informed of the strange phenomenon, the coronavirus, COVID-19. We were told that schools will be locked down with immediate effect. The arrangements will have to be made to continue classes remotely. This was a huge challenge. Our senior management team met and we started to brainstorm. The timetable committee was activated and was asked to produce Zoom timetables for the fifth form classes. There were several challenges. Internet issues, lack of devices, lack of interest, communication, among others. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the biggest headaches for us was the completion of SBAs. I have never seen teachers so stressed out. Teachers expressed their frustration during our Zoom staff meetings. Students were even under greater stress. Special thanks to the student support units of the Ministry of Education and our school's counselor, Mrs. Lewis. Much psychosocial support was extended to our boys and teachers. Let's give Mrs. Lewis a round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, through it all, our teachers and students stood tall. They were not giving up. Let's give our teachers again a round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2020 CXE CSEC results. A total of 126 boys sat CSEC exams. There were 938 entries in 27 subject areas. There were 714 passes and a pass rate of 76.12%. Top performances are as follows. 18 passes, Giovanni DeGans. 16 ones, 1:2 and 1:3. 16 passes, Sekou Sam. 13 ones, 2 twos and 1 3. 14 passes, Richard Francis. 6 ones, 7 twos, 1 3. Also with 14 passes, Jensen Thompson. 6 ones, 2, 3 twos, and 3 fives. And 5 threes, sorry. 12 passes, Ethan Etienne, Micah Noel, Brandon Peterson. 11 passes, Arian Andrews, Rene Duncan, Tendai Hokozi, Keshoy Taylor. 10 passes, Dereem Bain, Atenaten Hippolyte Lewis, Sofiane Matala. 9 passes, Shaquem Julian, Jamal Courtney. Ladies and gentlemen, of the 27 subject areas, 2 subjects fell under the 50% pass range, visual arts and mathematics. 3 subjects in the 50 to 59% pass range, Spanish, IT, and human and social biology. 1 subject in the 60 to 69% pass range, economics. 5 subjects in the 70 to 79% pass range, social studies, industrial technology building, chemistry, physics, and Caribbean history. 6 subjects fell in the 80 to 89% pass range, technical drawing, POA, integrated science, industrial technology, electronics, English A, additional mathematics. 5 subjects fell in the 90 to 99% pass range, POB, office administration, French, English B, agricultural science. And 5 subjects, at 100% pass range, PE, geography, food, nutrition and health, EDPM, and biology. Ladies and gentlemen, a further breakdown shows that 1 student got 18 passes, 1 student got 16 passes, 2 students got 14 passes, 3 students got 12 passes, 4 students got 11 passes, 3 students got 10 passes, 2 students got 9 passes, 17 students got 8 passes, 9 students got 7 passes, 16 students got 6 passes, 15 students got 5 passes, 18 students got 4 passes, 19 students got 3 passes, 8 students got 2 passes, 5 students got 1 pass, and 3 students didn't record a pass. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very pleased to report that Giovanni Degans with 18 passes and Sekou Sam with 16 passes respectively are GBSS and Grenada's top CSEC performers in 2020. Persons may remember that Giovanni made the GBSS and Grenada very proud after winning the local Brainbee competition and went on to compete in the international Brainbee competition held in Germany in the year 2018 and placed 2nd to the Polish competitor, only missing by 1 point. Giovanni was a Form 3 student at the time. Let's give him another round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, Let's just give our two top performers another lusty round of applause. In a year of lockdowns and uncertainty, the GBSS is pleased with the performance of our boys. All stakeholders must be commended for a job well done. The teachers worked extremely hard. Parents and guardians did their best. The boys answered the call. Let's give all our teachers, parents, and guardians a lusty round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to inform that the foundation that was laid over the last 5 years is a solid one. We are confident that all our graduates can move on to the next level. As I close, I must say a special thank you to our graduation committee, chaired by Mrs. Belfon, Lee, Dubisset, Sinclair Chaiton, Faray, Mrs. Abraham, Lord, Mrs. Hippolyte, Alexis, and Emmons. Thanks to all our teachers who have contributed to the process over the years. Special thanks to you, our parents and guardians of the subcommittee, who did a wonderful job decorating the Trade Center. Mrs. Cheryl Gibbs, Mrs. Reese Sam, Janelle Andrews, Sharon Thomas, Bessie Ann Penny, Jacob, Josh, George, Judy George. Special thanks to Amilcar George and Brent Phillip for the design and podium pennant. Judah St. Bernard for the confetti machine. Special thanks to Ms. Reese Sam and the Grenada Lottery Authority. Also to Mr. Roger Duncan and the Grenada Cooperative Bank. Also to Mr. Keishan Thomas, Susan Batiste, Mr. Lawrence Samuel, the chair covers, Debbie Samuel, floral arrangements. Your contributions are well appreciated. Thank you to our wider PTA executive and members for your overall support. Special thanks to the Ministry of Education for your support and encouragement. To you, graduates, we say thank you for staying the course. Congratulations, congratulations, congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, finally, I take this opportunity to wish everyone a very happy Christmas and a healthy and prosperous 2021. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Philip Thomas. Energy and persistence conquer all things, Benjamin Franklin. Here at the GBSS, we can boast of having a multitude of talented young men, but unfortunately, our health situation cannot allow us to showcase our talent this afternoon, but we will try to do so in a very small piece, but know that our young men graduating this afternoon are very talented, and we can only showcase a bit this afternoon because of our situation. And to do so, we are going to have a rendition by Musical Ensemble. They would be doing a piece entitled Memories by Maroon 5. Our musicians this afternoon, Orion Andrews, Rene Duncan, Sekou Sam, Jadon Sylvester, and Shavon Thomas. Let's put our hands together for this young man, please. like I said, they're talented, right? So let us give them another round of applause. That was pure talent. Okay, they can also write as well. Here at the GBSS, we focus a lot on writing, and our young men can write. And to share with us this afternoon, we have Richard Francis coming to do a poem entitled The Journey, and that poem was written by Richard himself. Let us put our hands together and welcome Richard.
The Journey. 5 memorable years have passed, each year earning a title of its own. Innocence, self-discovery, defiance, brilliance, identity crisis, hallmarks along the journey. Blessed by those who cared, we forged through from year to year. Interventions, discussions, prayers and tears, strategies used to change the untoward bunch. Deep inside, potential sought to blossom, stifled by a lack of vision and foresight. Patience, forgiveness, and understanding in good measure were poured out. The good old days are worth reminiscing, when things were pleasant and amusing. Little people with big dreams on their way to being fulfilled. Those gates were entered sometimes with joy, sometimes with a frown. We swam through adversity and cultivated infectious optimism. So teachers dear, remember not the pain inflicted on you so many times, not the wrinkles and gray hairs you've acquired through the years. Reminisce on who we've become. Your unwavering support and unconditional love were our gain. Immeasurable love we pour on you today. You were the wind beneath our wings. This is a time for looking back on lessons learned, adventures shared, bright moments filled with special meaning. A farewell to old friends, good times we've known. A beginning, a time to set new goals, to dream new dreams, to try your wings and see what lies beyond. Gone, gone, yes, gone into the endless labyrinth of yesterday. Those saddened, sweetened years of work, help, service, and achievement. All past, each measured by standards in our hearts. So, comrades all, this journey ends and another begins. Farewell. Remember this noble institution. The prize will always be to the one who earns it. This is our golden rule.
Thank you, Richard. We can do better than that. Let us put our hands together for Richard. We have another aspiring poet who wants to share with us this afternoon again. So let us put our hands together and welcome Jaquan Kutin, who will be doing a poem entitled 5 Years. And again, that poem was written by Jaquan. Let's put our hands together and welcome Jaquan.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My poem is entitled 5 Years. We came with a mind to learn, ambition not yet clear. We were little lads at the time, but we were proud to be here. Giggles here and there, we tried our best to be serious. We were taught that there was a cruel world out there, so we had to be ambitious. Made many, many memories, some we might regret. The final chapter of our first story, to those we lost on our way, we show our respect. A stepping stone of our life, our first taste of success. We are proud to be graduating from GBSS.
Again, thank you, Jaquan.
Come, let's put our hands together again for the boys, a resounding show of appreciation. At this time, we prepare ourselves to welcome a young man who had many exploits in his journey at the GBSS. And of course, Mr. Thomas spoke earlier of one of those, as he represented not only his family, his school, his nation, and came second in the Brain B international competition, but also in this COVIDious 2020, he rose to the challenge and was able to secure 18 passes, which had him being the head of the pack. And of course, the national scholar. And what is very interesting about this student is that, and I believe those who journeyed with him and those who know him, he's very humble, very soft-spoken, but under that quiet demeanor is one who time and time again rises to the challenge. And he has proven time and time again that when the dust settles, he can win. Let's welcome Giovanni DeGans, who is the GBSS 2020 valedictorian. Come on, let's welcome him heartedly.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Minister of Education, Human Resource Development, Religious Affairs and Information, Honorable Emily Pear, Chief Education Officer, Mrs. Angela Finlay, District 4 Education Officer, Mrs. Kerline Aban Marshall, Mr. Robert Phillip, Counseling Department, Ministry of Education, Pastor Stevenson Worm, Invocating Blessing of Rings and Benediction, Mr. Flavian Antoine, Member of the GBSS Governing Body, President of the GBSS Parent Teachers Association, Mrs. Nerissa Jilks, Past Headmaster of the GBSS, Mr. Victor Ashby, Mrs. Glenda Mason Francis, Parents and Guardians, Members of Staff, Graduates, Media Representatives, good afternoon. Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. Winston S. Churchill. I am quite certain that we can all attest to this ideology. The notion that success in any of our endeavors requires a deep-rooted sense of both conviction and boldness to achieve. It is for this exact reason that these past 5 years spent at the Grenada Boys Secondary School, though turbulent at times, were also so definitively prolific in bearing the many fruits of our hard labor. As such, it is a definite honor for me to assume the privilege of representing this graduating class via the delivery of this valedictory address for the year 2020. The completion of one's secondary school journey proves time and time again to be a moment of great significance. It marks the emergence of a novel wave of individuals, all being released from the molds into which they were injected and entering into the societies of the world as finished, polished products. It goes without saying that this prestigious institution, the Grenada Boys Secondary School, without a doubt, provides some of the highest quality molds there are to offer. And as such, I can be sure of the fact that I speak for each and every graduate within this hall here today when I say that the extensive 5-year journey, which ultimately converged towards this destination being commemorated here today, was indisputably more exhilarating. And of course, as is often purported, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Ladies and gentlemen, on September 7th, 2015, the graduating class before you entered the GBSS no more than mere fledglings, young boys emerging from a myriad of primary school systems and traditions to embark on a new journey. Some were undoubtedly encouraged to attend this great institution by their own fathers, grandfathers, brothers, and uncles, others by some other alma mater present in their life, and many by their own desire to attend the GBSS. One thing held constant throughout the majority of our experiences, however, being enrolled into such a new environment was a markedly disorientating sensation. However, like our fathers and forefathers before us, we persevered. Guided by the advisement of our many excellent form teachers, Miss Lord, Miss Smart, Miss Noel, Miss Abraham, Miss Hines, navigating the first form climate and the GBSS system in general, quickly became second nature to us. It really does seem like only yesterday when many of us were still so heavily preoccupied, not with schoolwork in a classical sense, but with the amount of time, effort, and energy put into running around the corridors, only to be reprimanded like clockwork by patrolling teachers and prefects. It really did feel like it stood as our primary task there. I know for sure that some of you, yes you, those first canings were your very own red carpet welcome into the GBSS. But those really were simpler, more fun times, despite the fact that they were ultimately eclipsed in the grand scheme of things. As the years went by, however, we really did mature as a group. With each subsequent form level came not only a greater workload, but also a greater responsibility for each of us, especially as the standing upperclassmen to newly incoming students. And in my opinion, no other form level we endured exemplifies this fact more accurately than our fifth form year. Never before in our GBSS journey had such a large collective effort been made to help our fellow students with their examination preparations. The 2020 year saw the creation of a myriad of study groups, with many boys going the extra mile and preparing for their CSEC examination along others into the late hours of the night. Many classes were pardoned to give time for the completion of our respective school-based assessments and labs. And even when this did not suffice, there were even instances where some groups remained in school overnight and on entire weekends, powered only by a strong sense of will, and of course, caffeine. Despite this, however, in lieu of any comments which may surface surrounding the idea of time management issues, no one can possibly truthfully say that the boys before you today were not as diligent and focused as humanly possible as the time winded down. This display of collective effort and a brotherly bond shared among us was only further illustrated during the onset of the COVID-19 virus, which plagued the global stage and crippled the standard, smooth operation of our school system. This only lends credence, however, to our adherence to the theme of this graduation ceremony, overcoming the global challenges and vicissitudes of life. We step purposefully into the future with God's guidance, as these unfortunate challenges and changes were certainly overcome. Throughout the months of March to June, each and every graduate here worked tirelessly to succeed, despite the daunting challenge facing them. And with the help and guidance of the many persistent teachers who often turned two-hour classes into 4 to 6 hour lectures, we were all able to obtain generally highly commendable pass rates in each of our respective subject areas, even if our specific grades fell out of the range and expectations of our predictions. Nonetheless, throughout our five-year journey, not only did we become more and more acquainted with the systems and styles of the Grenada Boys Secondary School, but also with our fellow students, with the graduates sitting here before you, ladies and gentlemen, and the other past and present students of the school. And I undoubtedly can wholeheartedly say that the Grenada Boys Secondary School has the most student talent, variation, and aptitude in any of Grenada secondary schools. I'm once again sure that it is this extent of pure talent and greatness that is a major cause for the strong and undying love and pride so heavily characteristic of GBSS's alumni and present students. While we may not all necessarily be able to attest firsthand to the achievements of those long before us, as a class, we can definitely see that our efforts within these 5 years have raised the proud head of our soon-to-be alma mater even higher than it already stood. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class before you today truly stood as a well-rounded, luminous symbol of excellence throughout the course of these past 5 years. Each of the following individuals were extremely dedicated to their craft and took on their roles as pillars of the GBSS with a serious yet confident attitude. In the area of athletics, many of the boys before you, such as Akil Francis, Deron Sharp, Jamal Mitchell, Ronaldo Parks, Morgan Coutain, Benjamin Etienne, and many others, were adept time and time again in surmounting insular boundaries, being integral facets to our victories in the Scotiabank Intercollegiate Games. The members of this 2020 graduating class were also integral in the victory experienced by the GBSS in the 2020 Subway Basketball Championship, beating PBC in the finals to secure first place. Commendable players present here today include Sekou Sam, Ronaldo Parks, Ronald Lambert, Trishon Thomas, Akinatan Lewis, Shakim Julian, and Zikumo Francis. I of course cannot fail to mention our cricketers here today, with individuals such as Jenson Thompson, Tendai Okosi, Sufian Mutala, and Sekou Sam, who absolutely succeeded in representing the school quite well. Within the area of football, many of our boys only further perpetuated the reputation held by GBSS for being a strong component of the football sphere within Grenada, with many boys here today even representing Grenada on the much wider regional stage. In this area, names such as Ethan Tellisford, Devontae Lewis, Trishon Thomas, Ronald Lambert, Micah Noel, and Benjamin Etienne undoubtedly and immediately come to mind. Our strong performances in swimming see the exemplification of names such as Dylan Fletcher and Tendai Okosi, even representing the school at a country and regional level. In the area of tennis and table tennis, both Sekou Sam and Jadon Sylvester truly embodied the meaning of the phrase, the prize to the one who earns it. And of course, in academia, the graduates within this graduating class truly did excel, pushing the boundaries of achievements already attained. Our performance in the SGU Knowledge Bowl, though cut short by the coronavirus pandemic, were ultimately highly promising this year, with myself, Sekou Sam, Tendai Okosi, Rashad Francis, and Akinatan Lewis displaying extremely amazing performances. Renee Duncan, Ariane Andrews, and Sekou Sam must also be commended for their amazing performance within the 2018 Grenlex debating season. The International Brainbee competition was also one in which we ultimately achieved greatness, once again placing this prestigious institution on the global stage. I would also like to deliver a hearty thank you to the various coaches who supported these teams of students on their journey to success in both athletic and academic greatness. Mr. Vaughn Joseph, Mr. Benjamin, Mr. Cuffey, Ms. Mitchell, Ms. Frame, Ms. Stafford, Ms. Abraham, Mr. Kwashi, Ms. Barry, your hard work and other efforts in uplifting the height of the school's achievements will never be forgotten. And of course, none of these would even be remotely possible without the aid of many of those who consistently made it their utmost duty to upkeep a strong interest in our developmental process throughout these 5 years. Our own stakeholders, if you will. First and foremost, we impart a strong sense of praise and gratitude unto God, who's the main driving force behind all our successes. Navigating the turbulent trials of our secondary school education, the workload, the number of painstaking hours required to be put in, and even the stresses, frustrations, and disjoints faced as a direct consequence of the COVID-19 situation with which we are currently faced, would all undoubtedly be much less manageable without the help of God. A heartfelt thank you is meted out to our teachers here at the GBSS. Your efforts in aiding us with the comprehension of all our required course material, the completion of our various CSEC syllabuses, and school-based assessments, and even in many cases, your help towards many of the students within this graduating class in coping with the plethora of challenges which life may have thrown their way, were all invaluable assets to us in our secondary school journey. A further hats off to all you teachers who really went the extra mile, extending a helping hand to us even while off duty. Mr. Charles, Rich especially, thank you for all your valuable time spent preparing us on Saturdays and Sundays. Your 4-hour-long classes and diligent and committed work, all in a time when we were effectively abandoned, were also invaluable to us, and your sacrifice is greatly commended, especially considering your recent graduation from this institution just 3 years ago. Ms. Barry, Mr. Joseph, Ms. Emmons, Mr. Sinclair, Mr. Lee, Senora Alexis, Mademoiselle Rubin, Charlo, Dr. Patrick, Mr. Ferre, and especially Mr. Sylvester, whose dedication and undying spirit undoubtedly still lives on. Please join me in a moment of silence as we remember Sylvester and the sheer impact which he had on us all. Special thanks are also extended to the parents of all our graduates. From each and every single individual within this graduating class, thank you. You truly stood as one of the major pillars in our secondary school lives, serving as mediums of support, structure, and even protection to us. We know it definitely was not an easy task, but we still purport an unmatchable level of gratitude toward you for putting up with us throughout all our years within this institution, all the good and bad reports, the phone calls home, and our extensive and varied performances throughout our academic career. Though our deep debt to you may never be repaid, I admonish you to take some level of solace in the fact that from today onward, you are now the proud parent of a GBSS alumni from the graduating class of 2020. And to our families, our grandparents, aunts, uncles, siblings, cousins, and all other supporters currently tuning in live to witness this ceremony, a large amount of gratitude is also extended to you. You have each played an insurmountable, critical role in each of our secondary school developmental journeys, whether through prayers, support, encouragement, or financial aid. While we all do desperately wish each of you could join in person today in celebrating this significant milestone, we do recognize the importance of the COVID protocols put in place. I do encourage you, however, to indulge in the pride of playing such an integral role in our development, as you have undoubtedly deserved it. A special thank you to you, the graduating class. I thank each of you for having the courage, aptitude, and patience which you so consistently displayed over the course of these 5 years. The diligence and strength to power through the inordinate amounts of work and other challenges which we all faced, and the continuity of these virtues, which I know you will take with you as we traverse through life's many paths. Especially when one considers the innate propensity for wild behavior which you started this journey with. I'm so proud of the fine young men that you have all grown into. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in lustily applauding all of these individuals for their hard work and the fruits of their labor. To the current students of this prestigious institution from which we are now disembarking, our younger brothers by educational affiliation, I would like to take this opportunity to implore you to make the most of every given moment within your educational journey. It is crucial for each of you to have a clear path of your future in mind, as it is this concrete plan which will allow for your inevitable success. As an individual who has held a common status with you all as a student of the GBSS, I am fully aware of the level of sheer talent and skill present within your various form levels. And as a result, I can confidently say that you can achieve any goal you set out to, provided that you place an adequate amount of effort into whatever your sights are set on. With the future of the GBSS as your canvas, I would like to strongly encourage you to paint a beautiful, vivid picture, one with the colors of dignity, strength, pride, and the achievements to back them all up. And last, but certainly not least, to my fellow GBSS graduates, my brethren with whom I have developed a most dear, everlasting bond over the past 5 years. Ensure to keep pushing. Ensure to always and forever hold dear to you the principles of non palma sine labore, no reward without labor. The GBSS spirit, the GBSS brand, the oomph, as our own Mr. Dubiset would so often ingrain into our mindsets, has now been rested on our shoulders. And naturally, as the prospective forerunners of society, we must indeed be willing and capable to accept and carry out valiantly this duty. We must advance with the help of God, the ever more applicable principles of this great institution, and go forth into each of our respective communities and the wider world in general, with the purpose of bringing only the most positive impact and our change into the lives of as many individuals as possible. I also leave you with a goal, which I've already imparted onto the members of my own class. I encourage each of you to work to be Googleable in the future, for the right reasons, of course. And now, in our final moments as students of the GBSS, I urge you, as we transition into alumni of this great institution, to not merely overcome life's vicissitudes and challenges, but to use them as stepping stones towards greater self-development. May we live by the saying, when I stand before God at the end of my life, I would hope that I would not have a single bit of talent left, and I could say, I used everything you gave me. May God grant us all his divine guidance and protection as we seek out our own unique path in life. You will each undoubtedly be greatly missed, but the memories we shared would certainly last a lifetime. And farewell to you, GBSS, on behalf of your proud 2020 graduating class. Thank you. Can I go with the photo?
Thank you, Gio. Young men, I think we can do better than that. He spoke on all of your behalf. The best preparation for tomorrow is doing your best today. We've come to the part of the ceremony where I think all young men are waiting or excited for, and that is the distribution of certificates. And to help us this afternoon, we are going to ask the Minister of Education, Honorable Emmeline Pierre, to assist us in this regard. Let us put our hands together and welcome Mrs. Pierre. Kai Lewis. Jadil Miller. Ronaldo Thomas. Shakir Lambert. Sheridan James. Kyle Hamilton. Jasper Benjamin. Giovanni Johnson. Meshack John. Kareem Albert. Lishon Blackett. McQuacy Jacob. Peter Dragon. Daryl Thomas. Alex Joseph. Nathan Ragbison. Dylan Fletcher. Alex Charles. Jadon Charles. Jaheim Lendo. Morgan Coutin. Alex Chetram. Levi Peters, Ethan Etienne, Kazim Garwe, Ethan Etienne, Nyron Dyram, Kasim Antwine, Kirby Jones, Giovanni Degans, Richard Francis, Ronald Lambert Jr., Jamal Bradford, Jonathan Gray, Tyreek Walcott, Shervin Thomas, Nate Samuel, Raheem Hines, Gentle McIntosh, Antoine Davenport, Roger Lewis, Caleb John, Shaquem Bartholomew, Leon Mitchell, Akil Francis, Tyrell McIntyre, Aquila Francis, Jamal Mitchell, Samuel Williams, Renee Duncan, Jensen Thompson, Shahid Dowden, Tyler Mitchell, Kishroy Taylor. Dereem Bain. Tendai Haukozi. Micah Noel Jr. Ruel Rubin. Chelon Wellington. Benjamin Etienne. Keldon Rodney. Jadon Sylvester. Sean Henry. Joshua Joseph. William Moore. Brandon Peterson. Khaled Patterson. Romeo Douglas. Ronaldo Parks. Ishad Isaac. Orion Andrews. Sekou Sam. Antoine Francis. DeAndre Alexander. Ethan Telesform. Dorian George. Akil Lewis Charles. Kristen Campbell. Chad McQuilkin. Bradley Andrews. Tyree Niles. Leon Jeffrey. Rishon Charles. Shaquem Julian. Tishon Paris. Darikel Fraser. Shondell St. Paul. Dante Penny. Nilon Garway. Tarek Solin. Giovanni Gittens. Makaya Duncan. Jaquan Kutin. Darren Sharp. Sufian Motala. Demetrius Viven. Ashton Patrick. Kevon Glud. Amy Chase. Shante Johnson. Zikomo Francis. Trelawney Bruno. Trishan Thomas. Hezron Richards. Jamari Wilson. Shaquan Julian. Devontae Lewis. Jamali Lendor. Congratulations, young men. We now call on Jadil Miller to give a token of appreciation to Mrs. Fear. Invite Shavon Thomas to do a piece on the saxophone entitled I Rise. Let us put our hands together and welcome Shavon Thomas. Thank you.
Okay, put your hand again together for Chevon Thomas. This is indeed a very unprecedented year. Many things happened differently this year. And one of the things that we will do differently in our graduation this year is that our feature address would be a virtual feature address. And it will be done by the governor of the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank, Dr. Timothy Antwine. Timothy N.J. Antwine is an economist and development practitioner who was born in Grenada. He has served as the third governor of the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank, ECCB, since the 1st of February 2016. Mr. Antwine holds a Bachelor in Science in Economics from the University of the West Indies, Cave Hill, and a Master in Science in Social Policy and Planning in Developing Countries from the London School of Economics. He invested 14 years of his life as Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Finance of the Government of Grenada. From 2005 to 2007, Mr. Antwine served as advisor to the Executive Director for Canada, Ireland, and the Caribbean, and was based in Washington, D.C. In 2016, he was the recipient of the Order of Grenada Gold Award for Excellence. In 2018, he was awarded an honorary doctorate in Humane Letters by St. George's University. In 2018 also, he received a certificate for outstanding leadership and public service from UWI Cave Hill, that is University of the West Indies, on the occasion of the university's 70th anniversary. Also in 2018, he was named Caribbean Central Bank Governor of the Year by Global Markets. Mr. Antwine is currently chairman of the Eastern Caribbean Home Mortgage Bank, chairman of the Eastern Caribbean Securities Exchange, and chairman of CCRIF SPC. Dr. Timothy N.J. Antwine is a graduate of the Grenada Boys Secondary School. Prepare now to hear the feature address from Dr. Antwine.
Minister of Education, Human Resource Development, Religious Affairs and Information, Honorable Emlyn Tehr, District 4 Education Officer, Mrs. Kerline Aben Marshall, Pastor Stevenson Worm, President of the GBSS Parent Teachers Association, Mrs. Nerissa Jilks, Headmaster of the GBSS, Mr. Philip Thomas, Headmaster Emeritus of the GBSS and Educator Extraordinaire, Mr. Victor Ashby CBE, members of staff, parents and guardians, graduates, GBSS old boys and old girls. Greetings from St. Kitts and Nevis. The year was 1987, and there I was, valedictorian and a proud member of the graduating class of the GBSS. Wonderful memories. The year is 2020, and here we are, about to discharge 122 young men of the GBSS. Class of 2020, what a year. But against all obstacles and odds, you did it. Parents, guardians, teachers, and friends, behold the fruits of your labors. Please join me in a rousing applause for our graduates. I wish to thank Headmaster Thomas, a UWI classmate, and the organizing committee for their kind invitation to deliver the feature address. This is my third feature address at a GBSS graduation. The previous occasions were in 2005 and 2009. At this juncture, I wish to commend the GBSS on navigating an exceptionally difficult year. Against that backdrop, I especially commend the GBSS on its success in the 2020 CSEC examinations, which included securing the top two performances on Ireland. In this regard, I make special mention of the exceptional performances of two graduates, Giovanni De Gans, who secured 18 CSEC subjects, 16 grade ones, one grade two, and one grade three, the highest number of subjects attempted and passed in the 135-year history of the GBSS. And Sekou Sam, who secured 16 subjects, 13 grade ones, two grade twos, and one grade three. Gentlemen, the sky is the limit. Now go for it. I now turn to our theme, overcoming the global challenges and vicissitudes of life, we step purposefully into the future with God's guidance. Vicissitudes of life. Vicissitudes are the things life throws at us, often when we least expect, and sometimes unpleasant and unwelcome. Like the COVID-19 pandemic, which has upended our world and our lives, and which has forced me to deliver this address virtually rather than in person, as I would have much preferred. The first time I recall hearing this big word, vicissitudes, was actually from the mouth of the legendary Victor Ashby, my former English teacher and the longest serving headmaster of the GBSS. I pay tribute to Mr. Ashby for his colossal contribution to education, the GBSS, Grenada, and his remarkable global impact. Mr. Ashby, sir, may God continue to richly bless you. This grateful old boy says thank you for everything you have done for me and the GBSS. On a sad note, I wish to acknowledge the valuable contribution of the late Jeff Fisher, groundsman and school barber, among many other things. Mr. Fisher will always be remembered by our GBSS family with affection and gratitude. The global challenges. Today, global challenges abound, with the COVID-19 pandemic at the very top. What started as a health emergency has evolved into a full-blown economic crisis with devastating effects on lives and livelihoods. According to the World Economic Forum's 2020 Global Risk Report, our global challenges include climate change and clean energy, rising inequality and social cohesion, digital fragmentation and cybersecurity, and severely stressed healthcare systems. Our tourism-dependent region is now experiencing the largest economic shock on record. That said, I remain confident that our region will recover and emerge stronger and more resilient starting next year. Today, I am pleased to confirm that our EC dollar remains strong. The backing in foreign reserves is 97%. If there is one word that sums up both our global challenges and the vicissitudes of life, that word is uncertainty. Our world today is pregnant with uncertainty. And in times of uncertainty and disruption, leadership is especially important. The GBSS has a proud and enviable record of producing high-caliber leaders at all levels of society, including heads of government and heads of state. Of course, it would be remiss of me
not to mention en passant that the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank has had three governors, two being products of the GBSS, the late Sir K. Dwight Venner and your humble servant. Grenada and our world will continue to need and demand leadership that is people-centered, positive, principled, and potent. My first leadership lessons were at home, and my first public speaking opportunities were at church. However, I am eternally grateful to the GBSS for cultivating my skills in both arenas. That included my role as head boy and years of debating, which culminated in my role as student prime minister in a student parliamentary debate. Graduates, in the time remaining, I wish to offer you some suggestions organized around the acronym of our beloved alma mater, GBSS. G. G stands for God and a growth mindset. Suggestion number one, put God first. My mother, a master educator and retired primary school principal, often said, "You can have more degrees than a thermometer, but if you do not know God, you are a fool, an educated fool." And why so? Because Psalm 14:1 warns that the fool has said in his heart, "There is no God." But that is not all. Educated fools often become clever devils. You see, graduates, education is extremely important, but you need a moral compass to guide you throughout your life. Each of us must have a core, our values, and a code, how we live. Please avoid the common tendency and grave mistake to embrace God as a child and abandon Him as an adult. Far too often, people demote God when they begin to receive their promotions and only run back to Him when they encounter trouble. Does anyone recall the famous story of David and Goliath? Goliath was a giant over 9 feet tall. To David, a teenager like you, Goliath seemed like a mountain. And yet, David defeated Goliath because he trusted in his God and went to battle in the name of the Lord. Against all odds and the pundits, David won. Graduates, put God first. Trust Him in everything that you do. Suggestion number two, adopt a growth mindset. A growth mindset, in contrast to a fixed mindset, reframes problems as opportunities, failures as lessons, and criticism as feedback. Graduates, a growth mindset will set you up for lifelong learning and render you relevant for opportunities and more resilient in times of adversity. B. B stands for balance. So here's suggestion number three. Strive for emotional balance. The vicissitudes of life mean that as you navigate life, you will experience highs and lows. One of my mantras is never get too high, never get too low. Repeat that with me. Never get too high, never get too low. Yes, we are human, but strive with God's help to avoid the emotional roller coasters where you swing from one end of the emotional spectrum to the next. Strive for emotional equilibrium, balance. Celebrate the highs without going over the top. And when the lows arrive, avoid getting too down and descending into depression. Never forget, the GBSS graduate must be a leader who is even keel, capable of taking the good with the bad, rolling with the punches, while always moving forward. S. S stands for skills. Suggestion number four, keep skilling and reskilling. The late American futurist Alvin Toffler asserted, and I quote, "The illiterate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn," end of quote. Graduates, if you wish to stay relevant in a highly competitive world, you are compelled to commit to lifelong learning. I could never forget a conversation I had with an 18-year-old in Singapore when I visited in 2006. He told me he was in the process of retraining for a new career in digital technologies because his prime minister always says Singaporeans have to reskill to stay relevant. Hearing that from an 18-year-old simply blew my mind. No wonder Singapore has achieved greatness. Let's understand this. The children of Singapore, which by the way is the size of Dominica, are not brighter than the children of the Caribbean. They do not possess bigger brains or better brains. However, their brains are better trained and they have a growth mindset. Their education system recognizes from whence the jobs of the 21st century will come, the digital economy. That digital economy requires a wide range of skills, including advanced digital skills such as coding, software and app development, network management, machine learning, big data analysis, artificial intelligence, and cybersecurity. It also requires soft skills such as communication, creative thinking, teamwork, leadership, and entrepreneurship. Today, this combination of skills is referred to as STEAM: science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics. I commend the GBSS on its delivery of technical skills. However, I urge Grenada and our region to urgently refocus and revamp our education to focus on 21st century skills rather than subjects. Before moving on, let me briefly mention three areas where the ECCB is supporting the build-out of a digital economy in our region. First, digitization of the EC dollar. The ECCB is poised to become one of the first central banks to issue a digital currency. Very soon, we will launch DCash using blockchain technology. Second, Bright Sparks program. Since 2017, the ECCB has offered an internship program to our state colleges in information technology called Bright Sparks. To date, 5 students, including 2 from Grenada, have benefited from this program, and all are now permanently employed here at the ECCB. Third, Caribbean Digital Transformation Project, and this is with support from the World Bank. This project is geared to increase internet connectivity and access to digital financial services, access to e-government services, digital skills and entrepreneurship, and data protection and cybersecurity. Graduates, take responsibility for your skilling and reskilling. Never forget, you cannot lead if you do not read. May you stay not just forever young, but forever skilled. S. S stands for service. And here is suggestion number 5. Serve humanity. Could I see the hands of the graduates who wish to be great? Good. I see you. Yes, I see you. And I see you. Very good. The great Martin Luther King once said, and I quote, "Everyone can be great because anybody can serve." End of quote. About 14 years ago, I was at the World Bank having lunch with a senior officer when she asked me, "Where do you see yourself in 5 years?" I reflected briefly before replying, "Back in the Caribbean, helping to find solutions to our problems." She looked at me and I sensed she was not overly impressed. I think she may have been looking for something more definitive, perhaps a specific role, even a title. Perhaps it seemed that I lacked ambition. But truth be told, then as it is now, all I've ever wanted to do is serve. 14 years later, that remains my abiding passion: to serve my God, my country, and my region. Now, how did service become such a passion of mine? It started with my parents and the values they taught me. Today, my top life values are faith, family, and service to others. So let me ask you, what are your top life values? Write them down and be intentional about living them out. Throughout my 27 years of public service, I have faced rigorous examinations of both my character and my competence. And the principle that has always guided me is found in Colossians 3:23. And I quote now from the New International Version: "Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human masters." End of quote. Graduates, focus on service. Focus on serving others and maximize your humanity. Now, before I move on, I must warn you. When you serve, please expect criticism. And understand that not all criticism is bad. In fact, here at the ECCB, we say feedback is a gift. You may not always like it, but it's a gift. I have a very simple approach to criticism, and it's this: truth or trash? Two buckets. If it is truth, tough as it may be, I embrace it and I get better. If it is trash, I dump it, stay focused, and get on with the job. In conclusion, I congratulate the graduating class of 2020. You will never forget this year. Now and forever, you are to be proud alumni of the GBSS. I have high and every expectation that Grenada and our world will be well served by this cadre of young men exiting the hallowed walls of the GBSS today. As you travel on the road called life, please remember that GBSS also stands for God and a growth mindset, balance, skills, and service. Graduates, put God first and adopt a growth mindset. Strive for emotional balance. Keep skilling and reskilling, and serve humanity. And now, go forth and help build our world. God bless you. I thank you all.
We express our sincere gratitude to Mr. Entwine, and I hope none of his words fell on deaf ears. It was good food for thought, and I hope that you take into consideration all that Mr. Entwine would have said this afternoon. Okay, we come to a very novel aspect of our graduation ceremony. This is the first time we are having such an aspect, and it's only because of the COVID-19, of course, and we cannot have our annual speech night exercise. So we are going to award or give some special awards to our fifth form students, our graduating class. And of course, we are going to start off with inviting Mrs. Kerlin Aben Marshall, District Education Officer, to assist in the distribution of our special prizes this afternoon. Let us welcome Mrs. Marshall. We are going to start off with our top performers from our CSEC, CXC exams. First, Giovanni DeGans, 18 passes, 16 ones, 1, 2, 1, 3. And his prize is donated by Antillian Group, Radisson Beach Resort, and generous GBSS Old Boys. Second place performer, Sekou Sam, 16 passes, 13 ones, 2 twos, and 1 3. And his prize is donated by Mr. Leslie Oliver and Claire Harbour. Third place performer, Richard Francis, 14 passes, 6 ones, 7 twos, and 1 3. And his prize is donated by Unicomma Grenada Limited. We also have some very other commendable performances. Jensen Thompson, 14 passes, 6 ones, 3 twos, and 5 threes. We also have Micah Jr. Noel, 12 passes, 7 ones, 5 twos. Ethan Etienne, 12 passes, 3 ones, 7 twos, 2 threes. Brandon Peterson, 12 passes, 1 1, 4 twos, 7 threes. Orion Andrews, 11 passes, 7 ones, 4 twos. Renee Duncan, 11 passes, 5 ones, 4 twos, 2 threes. 10 die, how cozy, 11 passes, 4 ones, 5 twos, 2 threes. Kishroy Taylor, 11 passes, 1 1, 3 twos, 7 threes. Dereem Bain, 10 passes, 6 ones, 4 twos. Akenaten Hippolyte Lewis, 10 passes, 3 ones, 3 twos, 4 threes. Sufayan Motala, 10 passes, 1 1, 5 twos, 4 threes. Shakim Julian, 9 passes, 7 ones, 2 twos. Jamal Courtney, 9 passes, 3 ones, 3 twos, 3 threes. The student who demonstrated academically no reward without labor, and we have two students here, and their prizes are donated by Mrs. Anthea Bullen Williams, Zikomo Francis, and Kyle Lewis. Best all-rounder, Sekou Sam. The student who contributed most to the life of the school, and that prize is donated by Digicel Grenada. That young man is was our head boy. He was involved in the Knowledge Bowl, Brain Bee champion for Grenada, and of course, second place worldwide. And of course, that second place was by only 1 point. He recorded local performance at the 2020 CSEC CXC exam, and of course that's a first for Grenada. First time anyone is recording 18 CXC passes. Academic motivation to students, and of course that person is no other than Giovanni DeGans. And if Gio can do it, I can do it, you can do it. Let us first put our hands together and welcome Gio. I now call on Tendai Haukozi to express gratitude to Mrs. Marshall, Eben Marshall. The graduating class of 2020 want to express thanks to all parents this afternoon. Now, as per tradition, we would love, or they would love rather, to give a token of appreciation to every parent here this afternoon. But of course, That's not quite possible this afternoon. So what they have decided is they are going to appreciate one parent, give a token to one parent, and this is from the whole graduating class to every parent here this afternoon. Again, they want to express their thanks, they want to express their gratitude towards you, and they wish or they hope that every parent could have come up here this afternoon. Time permitting and the whole COVID-19 experience, we cannot do that. So what we are going to do, they would have selected one parent, and that parent is accepting that token on behalf of all parents of the 2020 graduating class. And that parent they would have chosen is Mr. Cheryl Gibbs, and we call on Giovanni to come to present to his mom. Ms. Gibbs. Let us show some appreciation. Thank you. Thank you, Kyle. That's a
sick one. Okay, let's put our hands for all the parents who celebrate an awesome journey of their boys who graduate today. We now invite Sekou Sam, who will do the vote of thanks. So let's warmly receive him.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Minister of Education, Human Resource Development, Religious Affairs and Information, Honorable Emmeline Pear, Chief Education Officer, Mrs. Angela Friday, District 4 Education Officer, Mrs. Curlene Ebon Marshall, Mr. Robert Phillip, Counseling Department, Ministry of Education, Pastor Stevenson Womb, Mr. Flavian Antoine, member of the GBSS governing body, president of the Grenada, the GBSS Parent Teachers Association, Ms. Nerissa Jilks, past headmaster of the Grenada Boys Secondary School, Mr. Victor Ashby, Mrs. Glenda Mason Francis, parents, guardians, members of staff, graduates, media representatives, good afternoon. Our greatest weakness lies in giving up. The most certain way to succeed is always to try just one more time. Thomas Edison. I am honored to be granted this opportunity to extend a very heartfelt thank you to everyone that has played an integral role throughout our journey. You, the ones that have stuck beside us, are the persons we speak of. You weathered the storm with us, and when the going got tough, you stuck beside us. You rightfully are present here today to see the fruits of our labor. Firstly, on behalf of the graduating class of the Grenada Boys Secondary School 2020, I would like to extend a very wholehearted thank you to the following persons: Minister of Education, Human Resource Development, Religious Affairs and Information, Honorable Emmeline Pear; for doing the honor of helping with the distribution of certificates. Thank you, Madam. District 4 Education Officer, Ms. Curline Eban Marshall, for assisting with the presentation of prizes. Your assistance was surely appreciated. Pastor Stevenson Womb, for the invocation. Your contribution was greatly appreciated as well. Governor of the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank, Dr. Timothy Antoine, for doing the feature address. Even in your absence, we extend our sincerest thank you possible for your words of wisdom, and we would also like to assure you that we would put them into good use, which extends along the course of the rest of our lives. We would also like to show appreciation to Mrs. Glenda Mason Francis for your presence here today. We are fortunate to have you with us, especially with the efforts you made today. Thank you, Madam Francis. To the old boys who contributed to today's session, namely Amilka George, Keyshawn Clovey, Brent Phillip, Junior St. Bernard, and all the honored benefactors who contributed towards the prize table. Thank you for your contributions made. To the decorations committee of the PTA, namely Janelle Andrews, Sharon Thomas, Bezian Penny, Judy George, Reese Sam, and Cheryl Gibbs, we say thank you for your efforts made leading up to today, and also for a job well done. Other noteworthy mentions: Keyshawn Thomas, Suzanne Batiste, Lauren Samuel, Debbie Samuel, and the Grenada Trade Center. We say thank you for your contribution, for your kind contributions made towards this prestigious day. Chief Education Officer, Mrs. Angela Friday, Principal, Mr. Philip Thomas, Counseling Department, Ministry of Education, Mr. Robert Phillip, Member of the GBSS Governing Body, Mr. Flavian Antoine, President of the GBSS Parent Teachers, the GBSS Parent Teachers Association, Ms. Nerissa Jilks, Past Headmaster of the GBSS, Mr. Victor Ashby, members of staff and media representatives, thank you for gracing us with your presence today. To the proud parents and guardians here today, you did it. You successfully sculpted young men ready to go forth into the world. Young men who can make an immense impact on today's society. Without you, none of this would ever be possible. We are grateful for all the things you have done for us, including the multiple scoldings and the occasional annoyances. As a result, look where they have taken us. We've come a very long way, and because of you, we are of the mindset that we can't stop now. Not now, not ever. You showed us what it really means to make do with the resources one might possess. The countless sacrifices you made for us have not gone unnoticed. We saw them and their positive effects on our lives. And for that, we would like to reiterate the sincerest thank you possible. To my fellow graduates, we've done it. The five-year journey we embarked on has finally concluded. Being here today is truly symbolic of success, resilience, and mental fortitude. This year really emphasized on the true strength and toughness in ways we had not anticipated. However, we must not forget our teachers and principal, our educators, who have been there each day throughout our years. Notice the use of the word educators, as they have done much more than covering the required content in order to prepare us for our exams. They have taught us some lessons that I'm sure we will never forget. And for that, I say thank you. As for me, the lesson which stood out most was that hard work never goes unnoticed by the ones who truly want to see you succeed. And that the best way to make a statement is by working hard on achieving your goals, through which you would prove yourself. The things you've done for us, this makes this thank you somewhat ineffable. However, teachers, we still say thank you for assuming the role of parents while we are away from our primary home. We are blessed to have had you, and you will never be forgotten. Special thanks goes out to Mr. Rich Charles, who stepped up to the plate when we needed him the most in the areas of additional mathematics and electrical and electronics. You're truly a blessing to us as an old boy, and you significantly contributed to your alma mater. I myself have had some challenging times throughout the course of my years, all of which have molded me with the ability to withstand any challenges as well as persevere when they arise. One of those tough times was the passing of Mr. Showin Sylvester. We love you, Silvo, gone but will never be forgotten. Lastly, to friends, whether close or distant, we have helped each other to achieve our very best. As for my friends, they are the ones that pushed me to my limits. They are the ones who were there for me on a daily basis when I had rainy days as well as sunny ones. They too are the ones that made school times fun. I am of the belief that laughter is a key. I'm of the belief that laughter is key for mental and emotional health, which helps with achieving your goals in the long run. They are the ones that ensured that I had that omnipresent and sometimes inextinguishable humor. My physics teacher, Mr. Kelvis Joseph, often makes the statement that you are a reflection of the people you have encountered in your life. I'm lucky to have had the friends that I have, to have formed bonds that are surely unbreakable, and to watch them achieve great things beside me. Therefore, to you, I say thank you.
Let's put our hands together for Sekou, because we thank him for presenting the vote of thanks. At this time, you are going to be treated with a very important aspect of today's exercise, where we would have the graduation pledge by the graduating class of 2020, the changing of tassels, and we will do this GBSS school song. It will be sung by the graduates, the members of staff, old boys and old girls. However, we will reserve and have reserved the last stanza to be sung only by the graduates. So at this time, the graduating pledge, the graduates will start with the graduating pledge. Song, right? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for the graduating class of 2020, the new GBSS alumni. This time, I invite the members of staff, old boys, old girls, to stand as we sing the GBSS school song. And if we can, let us raise the roof. And again, we reserve the last stanza for the graduates. All right, we have to do it without accompaniment, so we proceed. At study or recreation, in classroom or playing field, let those of each generation respect to tradition yield. The feats of fathers and brothers are beacons marking the way. The torch handed on by others, we must keep alight today. The prize to the one who earns it, let this be our golden rule. Endeavor enhances merit, the slacker is folly's tool. The also ran and the champion, each one can but do his best. The winner's display depends on the efforts of all the rest. To be in the van is not all, for each has to play his role. The team wins the match at football, though one man must kick the goal. The prize to the one who earns it, let this be our golden rule. Endeavor enhances merit, the slacker is folly's tool. In term time or in vacation, uphold alma mater's name. Whate'er the place or occasion, remember to play the game. To win and be sporting is easy, to lose with a smile is hard. And yet, to the sportsman, rarely the game is its own reward. The prize to the one who earns it, let this be our golden rule. Endeavor enhances merit, the slacker is folly's fool. Only the graduates? Together, the prize to the one who earns it, let this be our golden rule. Endeavor enhances merit, the slacker is folly's tool. Thank you. Let us join the boys in standing as we share
once again in singing the national anthem, after which we will have the reception of the graduates, followed by the departing of the official party or special invited guests. The national anthem. Hail Grenada, land of Oz, we pledge ourselves to thee. Heads, hearts, and hands in unity to reach our destiny. Ever conscious of God, and while the graduates remain standing, I invite the rest of us to be seated. The recession of the graduates. Very special moment. Just know that there'll be refreshment at the back in the annex for the graduates and the teachers. Again, we want to say thank you for coming and making this day extra special. Those who are here present in the hall, and also those who are viewing online with us, we want to say a very special thank you as we invite the official party, to led by the principal, to now depart. And following their departure, the rest of us will depart. Okay, the official party now departs and we will follow. And of course, the rest of us. And again, thank you. and have a safe journey back home.